to welcome onto centre stage a young man appearing in his very first major final in this country. Can I ask you to welcome the world number 20 and Thailand's number one sportsman, James Wattana. And his opponent, no stranger to the big time, and one of the most popular players ever to hold a cue, the world number 3, the whirlwind of London town, Jimmy White.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. First frame, Jimmy White, you break.
And the formality is over, and it's Jimmy White who breaks off in the final of the 1992 Pearl Assurance British Open Snooker Championship. And what a classic final this should be. Two of the most exciting players in the game. Jimmy White, one of the most popular and gifted players in the game. And James Wattana, who made that magnificent 147 break, and I'm sure this is a final that everybody's going to just sit back and enjoy, because, and don't blink, because these boys don't mess about. There'll be too many safety shots here this afternoon. Both very aggressive players.
James Wattana, 5.
And James was lucky just to get the dump on the middle jaw there, because he would have been on a red and would have left something for Jimmy. Another mistake there by Jimmy. And I think before this tournament had really been underway very long, if anyone would have picked the classic final, this would have been it.
One.
Play to come back off the cushion to get the black into the corner pocket. And if he takes this on now, it would be very risky. taking the pink or thinking about the pink, but pink or black. Both difficult. Cue ball going into the reds. This is risky.
A little bit unlucky.
Eight.
As to where the white has landed, but he's got a red that goes into the middle pocket. And if he can knock this in, he's almost certain to be on either the pink or the black.
Eight.
But the red stays out. And surely, amongst these reds, there must be one that Jimmy White can knock in. Nothing down into the corner pockets.
One.
Well, of these two players, Wattana has produced the most exciting snooker of all the players during the last week. Highlighted, of course, by the 147.
Eight.
And he's suddenly risen right to the top now of professional snooker. We're going to see and hear a lot more of Wattana. But Jimmy White really hit the highlights in the very final frame in yesterday's semi-final game against Steve Davis. He was absolutely brilliant.
Well, a lot of players here would just trickle up behind the colour, but I'm not too sure about Jimmy. He's such an aggressive player. Well, both these players are, for that matter. And that's why we expect this to be such an exciting final.
19.
These two players have met
20.
Five times, and James Wattana has won three of the encounters, so he knows he can beat Jimmy.
Yes, significantly, Rex. Wattana has won the last two confrontations.
28.
Was a lot more difficult 46. Than it seemed, and he's played a beautiful shot, knocking a red towards the pocket. He had to develop a red from that position.
Jimmy White, 43.
He's only two or three red from home in the first frame, and he misses what looked like to be a comparatively easy cut. And now James Wattana comes to the table, 30 points behind, but still in with a great chance.
One. Nine. Sixteen. Seventeen.
And James would have liked to have been in a position there on 24. That black to have disturbed the two reds, because he knows he would have still been on the red over the pocket.
24.
The two reds won't go, and it's difficult to disturb them.
25, James Wattana.
I'm not sure if there's a clamp there. Sure if he can knock the one red onto the other and pop the second red.
One.
Just gone a little bit too far. I'll have to pop the pink into the corner pocket and follow the throw onto the red. And Jimmy just had a quick glance at the score there, just checking the score.
11.
But that will tell him that he needs yellow, green and brown.
13. 16.
Well, what an entertaining opening frame this has been. If this is a sample of what is to follow, this is going to be a tremendous final.
20.
And a tremendous
31.
Opening frame, and Jimmy looks a little bit sharp. And he takes it.
38 in the frame.
Well, as you can see, I have Dennis Taylor with me. Both players had their chances there.
Yeah, it was a little bit of a nervy start from both of them, but you can expect that in the first frame, and James will be a little bit disappointed that had a shot that he missed there. We were talking
black.
About, well, in fact, it's on your screens now. Mm-hmm. And the two reds were a plant, which makes it even more disappointing to miss that. But he was rolling it to hold the white on that side of the table, and it's the first frame, so...
Is that nerves?
It probably is. It'll just take him a while to settle down. This is a big day in James's life.
And of course, it's 19 frames, the best of, which is a big contrast compared to 3 days ago.
Well, the players love playing that. The best of mine is hard work. It can be crucial to lose a frame and miss an easy shot like that, but there's plenty of frames to go at today.
And one other thing, I mentioned at the beginning of the programme about the speed snooker we've got coming up later. That was tremendous fun.
Looking forward to that, because you've got 8 amateurs from all over the UK that have qualified for it. They're in for a treat as well.
Okay, Dennis, for the time being, thanks very much. So, Jimmy has the first frame on the board. Frame 2 is next.
Second frame, James Wattana to break.
Second frame, James Wattana breaks off. Just one bad miss towards the end of the first frame, and that was it. First frame took just less than 13 minutes. Very difficult, really, to play half ball off the first red and expect to miss the red on the side cushion. Now the red does cut, it's very fine, into the middle pocket. Difficult, really, to totally control the wide ball when you're striking the object ball so finely. So where's it going to land?
One.
Oh, if the black goes into the corner pocket, he's had a result. So he hasn't had that result.
Yellow ball. One, Jimmy White.
That wasn't the best safety shot there from Jimmy. He should have kept the cue ball over the left-hand side of the table. And the reason for that is that there wasn't such an easy route back to the balk end. Reds were in the way, and Wattana could have collided with them when trying to get back there. And these are the kind of things that players must think about when they're playing their safety shots. It's not a matter of just leaving it safe and no pot on. It's making it awkward for the opponent with his following shot, trying to create an opening.
This time it looks as though the black may now go into that corner pocket. So if it will, we'll need to knock this red in and screw back a couple of inches or so, or more than that.
One.
Well, I'm a bit confused about that shot. It's possible perhaps the black doesn't go, but if he tried to get on the black by running through it, he certainly didn't make it. So got to play safe now.
Yellow ball. One, James Watson.
Yes, I think Jimmy was a good judge to have second thought about that shot. Looked rather dangerous.
One.
Useful fluke there. Just turned round and apologised to his opponent.
Five, Jimmy White.
Played it with slow drag, trying to play the gentlest of shots to finish on the black.
One.
So I suppose this really is the first real chance for James Wattana.
Twenty-three. 29, 30, 37.
And a wonderful brain this young man has got for the game of snooker. He knew he was leaving himself on this red, which he's missed.
37, James Wattana.
But the shot before was good because he didn't push the red too far, didn't want to cover the black pocket. But he's 32 points in front, and that may not be enough.
One.
Red on the right-hand side of the cue ball because the black one pot into the top right-hand pocket. So he decided to screw back onto the pink.
Nine.
Hasn't got the right angle here. The cue ball, he's going away from the reds when he pots the pink.
Sixteen.
21.
Wattana must be sitting there kicking himself. He was in prime position and missed what appeared to be a comparatively easy red into the corner. And
28.
Jimmy's break now standing at 28 is the result of the Wattana miss. And what looked like 29. Being one all in frame scores could well go 2-0 to Jimmy White now. 3 points behind. 'S still going to play some astute positional shots to see off the remaining two reds. Now he's got one of the reds into the top corner pocket, the one to the left of the
35.
Black. It's a difficult pot though.
36.
Well, it was a good pot, but he hasn't gone far enough. To get on this red, he'd have to go right round the table as he takes the black on.
35. And he's got to get very close to the ball, left-hand corner pocket. Well, that was a bit of a shot that Jimmy
36.
Tried there.
Jimmy White.
Not the kind of shot that I would want to be playing in the final of a major competition. Gee whiz, that was a bit ambitious. Screwing up the table with a tremendous amount of left-hand side.
1 8.
Not enough porridge for breakfast. Wanted at least another foot on the cue ball to get on the yellow. So both players actually have had their chances to win this second frame and haven't taken full advantage of them.
4, Jimmy White.
Not sure if the yellow will pot. Looks a very acute angle. Scores all level, 46 points each. And if the yellow will pot, he's still got to get out into the table a little bit to get onto the green. Difficult.
Nearly a snooker, but not quite. Just shave this yellow.
Well, it looked like being a reasonably good chance here, but fortunately for Jimmy, the cue ball just pulled up and left it awkward cueing over the top of the blue. And this is the most difficult implement to use. Didn't play the pot there, played the safety shot.
Well, he seems to know by instinct when to have a go. What a super yellow that was, and that really should win him this second frame. He needs the brown and the blue.
Nine.
Just needs to make sure of this blue ball.
14.
In it goes. So he'll be very happy, and young James will sit back, rearing about the couple of chances that he's spurned in the second frame. It could have been one all.
Jimmy White. 14.
So that's a good start for Jimmy White. James Wattana now requiring one snooker.
And the black is lying in the most difficult of positions to get a snooker. Just trickle it over the pocket now.
Six in the frame. Jimmy White.
And Jimmy White, then in the end, takes frame number two and now leads 2-0.
Well, Dennis, yet again, James had a chance earlier on, didn't he?
That's right. That red that stopped right on the lip of the pocket, he would have clinched the frame from that position the way he was going. So he could be 2-0 up, but he's 2-0 down.
And at the end, when he was trying to get a snooker, that seemed to me a very tall order, with just two balls on the table.
It was worth trying, but the black, as Rex Williams said, was in an awkward position. He had to get the pink and the white over to that side of the table. But This is one part of the game where James will improve over the next few years, and that's the tactical side of his game. He's got everything else. And in fact, I think Tom Moran, his manager, has got Ray Edmonds, former world amateur champion, in as an advisor, a snooker advisor, he's calling him. So maybe Ray will be working on things like that with James.
Yeah, because I presume that the tactical side of the game is something that comes later. I mean, it's learning to pot the first thing.
He's playing someone there, Jimmy White, who we said for years, as soon as he gets his tactical game sorted out, and Jimmy has said it, and Jimmy's reaping the benefits now.
So Jimmy is now two frames up. Frame three in a moment.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Third frame. Jimmy White, two breath.
And the third frame of the match. Jimmy White breaks off, leading two frames to nil. This match is scheduled for 19 frames, so the first player to win 10 will take the title. And those are risky shots. He could have easily have left a bundle on for Jimmy. He's fortunate to have left it under the side cushion.
Ball stroke, four, and a miss. James Wattana.
No advantage derived from where the balls lay, so James Wattana asking Jimmy to play from the original position. So that's 4 points Jimmy has given away. Trying to hit this red very fine. And even then caught it off the back cushion. And that's not a very good shot. The jaws of the middle pocket proving very kind for the young Thai.
One. Nine. 16. Seventeen.
A little bit unlucky. 24. He needed to just have a bit more forward motion on the white ball as he went into the pack. And it was a bit flat. He's got the long red into the yellow pocket. But he must be careful he doesn't leave a red on into the right corner. He's missed the pot by quite a long way.
24.
A little bit slow getting started today, James Wattana. He's been absolutely murderous around the black spot all the way through this tournament. Plenty of time for him to find his touch, though.
One.
Clip the brown in and get up the table onto the reds. Just wants to miss the blue when it's coming across the table with the cue ball. Just missed it.
Five.
Jim is 23 points behind, but the balls are beautifully placed.
Six. Thirteen. Twenty-one. Twenty-two. 29, 30.
And if James loses this frame, he's dropping a little too far behind for comfort. Just got a little bit of angle on this red to
37.
Send the cue ball off two cushions back onto the black. In fact, he was able to study it out, which was even better. 10 points in front now, Jimmy.
45. 46.
Can stand round the back of the two reds near the cue ball. Just wanted to clear the one behind the black first.
53. 54.
Hasn't worked out as intended, but being the left-hander, he can get across this red and clip it in.
62.
So 34 points in front, and this packed house here at the Assembly Rooms Derby thoroughly enjoying this final.
67.
Back will be enough.
Seventy-six. 81. 82. 87. 87 on the frame.
And a lovely 87 break, and Jimmy White takes the third frame, and he now leads 3-0.
Yeah, he's really motoring, isn't he, Jimmy? But even so, you know, James has been ahead in all three frames up to this stage. Dennis, there's something special about Jimmy White. The punters love him. What is it?
Well, you can see why. I mean, I've known Jimmy for many, many years and watched him so many times, and it's still a delight to sit and watch him playing like that. He is a very special and probably the most talented player the game's ever had.
But what exactly?
It's just the way he plays the game. I mean, he's tactically, he's improved tremendously, but the pots that he takes on, and he just plays them with so ease, and the cue power he gets, he hits the ball so easy but gets such a reaction. That's just a natural gift that Jimmy White has.
Yeah, so you think it's a sort of bravery that he has to go for things that you wouldn't go for?
Well, yeah, although he started to play the percentages more, but he takes more risks than any other player, and when he's like this, they come off, and he's just brilliant to watch.
But it can backfire, I suppose.
Depending on how things are going. It has done in the past, but it's certainly not at the moment. He's really on fire, isn't he?
Yeah, certainly is. Dennis, thanks very much for the time being. Let's move on then, as we move into frame four now, and James really needs to get things sorted out, and soon.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Fourth frame, James Wattana to break.
James Wattana breaks off in frame four. And the Typhoon has come off second best so far in this match. It's early stages yet in its battle with the Whirlwind.
One.
Everything seemingly going right for Jimmy White. And the converse applying to James Wattana. Doesn't look as though he can do any more than just make sure of the 7 points here. And then play safe.
13. 13. ball stroke, four, and a miss. Here's one.
Can Jimmy get through to the red? It's a close thing.
One.
Oh, and it's not a bad kiss either. Just composing himself. A rare moment as far as Jimmy White is concerned. He's one of the smoothest players you'll ever see around the table. No rough edges whatsoever. And once he comes through to the table, he usually glides around with no stopping in between except to deliver the cue.
Four. Nine. Ten.
Beautifully played, little cannon. Developing a further
18.
Two reds. So it's a real tough test now for this young man from Thailand. How does he cope with a rampant Jimmy White? Already three frames in the lead.
25.
And with a substantial lead in frame number four.
26.
One points in the lead.
32.
One red goes at the bottom of the little group of reds there.
Forty-one.
5 minutes into frame number four.
48. 49.
Now, will he keep potting and take the brown into the middle? A trifle risky. He's playing well, though. He might feel like knocking that in, or does he this time just make sure
green ball.
Players safety shot?
49, Jimmy White.
So, Jimmy White leading by 58 points.
Sixty-seven points left on the table. And when Jimmy played the safety shot on the green, he was just trying to put the green awkward. Could have triggered up behind one of the ball colours, but preferred to get the green awkward making it difficult for James to clean up should he get a chance.
One.
Needs to make sure of the blank now. 59 points in front, 59 on the table. That's the one that he wanted. Jimmy.
Eight.
Looks like going four in front.
Nine.
He's playing beautifully too. Oh, this is a little trundle behind the brown. May take it on because I don't think he feels he can lose the frame now.
Nine, Jimmy White. And the frame.
Oh, James Wattana has conceded, so Jimmy White takes frame number four and now leads by 4-0.
Oh, Jimmy's unstoppable. I shouldn't think he wants the break, actually. Do you?
Yeah, I think he would like to carry on, but James Wattana will certainly look forward to the interval, because sometimes it can turn the whole thing round and stop Jimmy flowing as it is.
Yes, it can sort of break the spell, can't it?
That's right, yeah. But he's going to have to sort of psych himself up again. But what a tough task he's got, just to get himself mentally right to come out for after the interval. Mm. He's got to think about all the good things that's happened this week and the maximum break he made. But there's so many emotions going on in the lad's head, it's going to be very difficult.
This is where a manager comes into his own, I presume.
That's right, yeah. I'm sure Tom will be there just telling him to go back out and enjoy the snooker.
Keep cool. Well, look, while they're taking a break, we're going to have that special look I talked about earlier at the speed snooker, so don't go away. Hello again from Derby. Well, now something that could well become very popular in snooker clubs throughout the country. It's the Pearl Assurance Pro-Am Speed Snooker Competition, which has been organised to raise money for sufferers of muscular dystrophy. Its aim is to pot the six colours as quickly as possible. It's fast, frenetic and loud, because our commentator is John McCrerick.
So let's see who can rocket them into the pocket. Only the quickest cue will do to enter the Guinness Book of Records as the world's fastest potter. Now heading the challenge are the 8 quarter-finalists in the British Open and 8 amateurs who've won throughout of thousands time by stopwatch in 500 clubs. The objective, to clear the colours in correct order against the clock. The cue ball can be placed anywhere on the table. Each player has 3 attempts and the fastest single time to 1/100th of a second to decide. And the winner receives this World Championship Speed Snooker Trophy. Now remember, for the rookies this is unknown territory. The lights, the camera, the hoopla, and of course the strange table. But the pros are under pressure too, not to be hot-potted by an unknown. So for the first group of 8, with their best attempts coming up, and they've got their mascot there, Rupert Bear, the muscular dystrophy mascot, though I don't think he'll be pawing the table, we'll join our compere Alan Hughes, who we all know is a right bandit on the bays.
And ladies and gentlemen, who better to start proceedings than the world number one, Stephen Hendry.
First of all, whatever you wish.
And Stephen, your time starts on the buzzer.
Ready? For Wonder Bear, and has he got a strategy? It's the time the cue ball is actually in movement. That is his time. He's not rushing, not he's taking his time, and he's got the rest for the Wonder Bear. That must be damaging for his chances now. Up to 15 seconds already. He's not halfway through. This is not a wonder effort from the Bairn yet. He bangs the blue. We'll see his split time at 22.72. That's the split time for the Bairn. 22.72. He's missed the pink. And that must put him out of contention in the first round. The Wonder Bairn himself. Has he got a strategy? Lining up on the green. It is the time the cue ball is actually in motion. That's what takes the time. The Bairn didn't rush around for that. He lost valuable seconds on the brown. He's now up to 12, 13 seconds already. He's on the right side of the blue. Waiting for his split time. That's the key to it. His split time for the Bairn is 20.64. 20 seconds, 0.64 for the Bairn on his split time. Perfect on the pink. In goes the pink, and now on the black. This is setting the target time already. And the time for the Wonder Bairn, 32.51.
The idea really is to try and keep on the same side of the table all the way through, which I failed to do miserably.
So what advice would you give, especially to the amateurs here?
Just pot the balls.
Wonder, Van. Thank you very much.
All right, Steve, your second attempt then on the buzzer.
So the master cueman himself. If any player has a strategy to crack the system, it must be him. Perfect. Still doing well on the brown. Now this is the key shot onto the blue. Let's see his split time. The best split time of the Wonder Band was 20.64. The Cuman could beat that. And he has 19.62. That's the fastest at the halfway. In with a pink he goes. The time to beat is 32.51. It looks like the Master Cuman's going to do it. And he does! The Master Cuman 30.10.
Some of the lads, the amateurs, are going to find it quite hard because of the speed of the table. And it's actually the time, really, that the ball, the white ball, takes to stop rolling. And on some of the club tables, it stops rolling a lot quicker. So, hard to control.
Is there a special plan that they should adapt?
I think, in the right sequence, yellow to black.
The master cueman.
And your final attempt on the buzzer.
Mevlet from Thornton Heath in Surrey gets the yellow in. I mean, nervous, emotional time for the young man. Rushing round there like a deranged chicken, I thought. Trying to get on the brown. And he's made it. Now, where will he be on the blue? This is the key shot. The split time to beat 19.62 on the split of the Master Cuman. And he's beaten it. He's in front on the clock. Mevlet is in front of the Master Cuman and the Wonder Bear on the clock.
Keep going, keep going.
Ah, but he misses the pink. And that knocks him back on time. He cannot possibly win now. In goes the pink, but he's done on the time. The time 30.10 to beat. Maybe a good effort, but just missed it out on the pink.
And Ken's final attempt on the buzzer.
Ken, snooker's rising young star. Let's see what strategy he employs. On the green, he's got to go round, but look at the time he's taken. That's the time the cue ball was still there for 5 or 6 seconds. Onto the brown now. Will he be able to line up on the blue? And he has. And he's perfectly placed. Looking to beat the split time of 19.62 of the Master Cuman. And he is in front. Ken Doherty in front on the split times. The time he's got to beat is 30.10. In goes the pink. Get the black to take the lead. Taking the black. In he goes. A masterly time by Ken Doherty. And takes the lead over the Master Cuman and the Wonder Band.
Right, sir.
We've reached the halfway stage, and no illusions now as to just how tough the speed challenge is. Not one of the four amateurs, and they're the pick from thousands taken from clubs right round the country, has even managed a clearance. An early talk of about 20 seconds being the time has proved way out. But as in golf, they say the leader in the clubhouse, well, it's Ken Doherty. He's got a time of 29.47 from Steve Davis, 30.10, and Stephen Hendry, 32.51. But there's a storm brewing. The whirlwind and the typhoon have blown into town.
And Jason, your final attempt starts on the buzzer.
Ready? In with the yellow, Jason. Good start for him. And the green. He's moving fast. Now look at that for a big man. My goodness, he moved fast for that. Brilliant on the brown. He's lining up the green. We're going for the fastest split time, which is 17.78. Yeah, he won't be the fastest split time, but it's rolling in. In goes the blue for Jason. He's coming onto the pink. Can he be the first amateur to get a clear round? In with the... Oh, no! And the pink just missed on the corner. Terrific effort there by Jason. Almost made it. Still going on the pink.
Yeah,
bangs the pink in. Comes round for the black. Inga, well done, Jason. Well done. Well done.
And James, your first attempt starts on the buzzer.
The typhoon, many people's favourite to make it. Look at this, the fastest player in the game. Many people believe racing round there. Perfectly on the brown, the typhoon. In he goes, and he's on the blue. He's on the blue for the split time. Will he beat the record split time? His split time is 16.89. He is in front of Ken Dock and his time. Can he make the pick? Oh, he misses the pick, the typhoon.
And ladies and gentlemen, the next contestant is the man who invented this game of speed snooker, the 1979 world champion, Terry Griffiths. And Terry, in your own time, your first attempt starts on the buzzer.
Terry Griffiths, the fastest man out of the West. Look at that. In goes the yellow and the green. And Terry running. Look at Terry. Have you ever seen Terry run? Well, look at that.
On,
why does he play like this all the time, we ask ourselves. Bang goes in the brown. He's on the blue, Terry. Waiting for it. Split time 17.51. Leads on the slit. Terry's got the fastest time on the slit. Waiting for the pink. He's on the red. This is the old Terry Griffiths. There he is. He's always, Jimmy White there cannot believe it. Good old Terry Griffiths. Waiting on the bank. Rolls it in. The crowd roaring. This to win the world title, Terry. Bangs it in. And the crowd love it. A time of 41.84. That's the kind of Terry Griffiths we never see.
What do you mean by that?
Well, you should always play like that.
I'd miss them all the time, you mean, yeah.
No, you didn't, rushing around the table, everything like that. It was great fun.
I took some pills last night.
Terry Griffiths,
and Jimmy, your second attempt starts on the buzzer.
White knuckle time for Jimmy White. This is the kind of game that suits him. The crowd roaring him on as they were earlier. Come on, roar on Jimmy White! He's right round on the brown. This is a key shot to get on the blue. He's perfectly placed. Look for his split time now. He looks as though he'll beat the split time if he can get the blue in. And he does. And he's in front on the split. In front of Ken Duck and his time on the split, Jimmy. He's on the pink now, perfectly placed for that. This is Jimmy's time. Coming round to beat 3.947. Can he do it on the black? He's done. And Jimmy is beaten by 0.02 of a second. He fails by 0.02 of a second. Ken Doherty still leads by 0.02 of a second. 3.947 for Ken Doherty, 3.949 for Jimmy White. It's white knuckle time for the whirlwind, the game that should suit him. Speed snooker, suited of all players in the world, you'd have thought of Jimmy White. That's how he normally plays, rushing around the table like that. On the brown, he's perfectly placed on the blue. Let's see his split time against 17.78. A great split time! He's a second and a half in hand on the split. He's perfectly on the pink to beat Ken Doherty. He's on the back, the crowd are roaring him out. He's going to do it only the back, and Jimmy White! A monster round from Jimmy White in 26.01. Over 3 seconds, he beats Ken Doherty's time. A brilliant round, Jimmy. Absolutely brilliant. And how the crowd love it. A magnificent round. Well, people said beforehand, if anyone was favoured, it was you, Jimmy. A brilliant round.
Thanks for putting me on last. No, the key shot is the brown to the blue. If you come to the right side, then, you know, perfect position, you can do it.
Jimmy White, well done. We all knew the whirlwind would do it. He did, blowing away Doherty and the Master Cueman, the only amateur to finish Jason McDonald 49.25, though all eight in their clubs had times of less than 20 seconds. It just shows the tension, cameras, lights on the table, find out even the finest rookies. And now, yet more silver for the whirlwind's already well-stocked trophy room.
If you just joined us, don't think that that's part of the British Open final, will you? I'm glad to say that that raised, altogether, produced £65,000 one way or another for the sufferers of muscular dystrophy, so it was well worthwhile, and I think it could well catch on. Now, Dennis, I presume watching that, you picked up a few tips about how to be a commentator.
Dear me, John McCrerick, he was blaming the lighting and the table on the amateurs not doing well. I mean, to have to listen to him shouting there, it must have absolutely frightened the life out of him. But he did a brilliant job, to John McCrerick. The only man that can get a set of billiard balls in his mouth and not get a cannon. Sorry, John.
I'm still waiting for him to be offered the part of Doctor Who as well, aren't you?
Unbelievable. Clothes are incredible. Don't know who he got them off.
Have you ever had a go yourself at that sort of
thing? We did a thing for Granada Television a good few years ago, and I think I managed to do it in about 31, 32 seconds. But it's great fun. I think the people will enjoy that.
Yeah, it was terrific. Well done to everyone involved. Now, it's a great day, obviously, so far for Jimmy White, leading 4-0 in this final of the British Open. But not so for James Wattana, but he does have a memory to treasure from this week, as we all do, from Tuesday afternoon.
And this young man at the table in tremendous form this afternoon. James Wattana. the pride of Thailand.
And Bradford, John, as well, where he lives.
Eight. Nine. Sixteen. Seventeen.
15. A little bit of a stretch this time, but he still should manage the black. 16. And developed another few reds there.
24. 25.
But this one's gone a little bit astray.
32. 33. 40. 41. 48. 49.
Well, that couldn't have worked out better if he'd placed it there by hand. There's no way of knowing exactly where the cue ball's going with a shot like that.
56.
That one worked out absolutely perfectly.
57.
And there's no stopping this young man this afternoon. He's in tremendous form.
64. 65.
Don't like saying it, but you can see it on your screen there. Nine 72. Reds, nine blacks. A prize 73. Of £25,000 should any player make a maximum break. 72. So I'm not going to say any more and just let him get on with it.
80.
80. Yes, I'm with you, Dennis.
81.
It's what we've come to call the kiss of death from the commentary box. As soon as we start talking about these things, the player misses an easy shot, so we'll shut up and let you watch.
88. 89. 96. 97. 104. 105. 112. 113. Quietly, please. Thank you. 120. 122. 125. 129. 134. 140.
There, a break of 147 from James Wattana. That will collect £25,000 for him.
Car, fantastic. Only the fourth ever on television, and the fastest ever on television, 7 minutes and 8 seconds. And Dennis, you were commentating on it.
I had the privilege of being in the commentary box, Nick. I've been a professional snooker player for 20 years, and there's certain things you'll never ever forget, and that will stick in my memory for as long as I live.
And in fact, you got an inkling a long time ago, and there was still 70-odd on the table that he was going to do.
Yeah, and so did James. He knew once he'd got five blacks, the way the reds, he'd opened them up, he was in with a chance, because you're always trying for a maximum break. That's the ultimate.
Yeah, well, it was great to watch, and I think we'll all remember that with great pleasure in the weeks to come. Well, now it's on with the British Open final. The players' interval almost over. Jimmy White leading James Wattana. 4-0. Frame 5 is next.
Fifth frame. Jimmy White, you break.
Jimmy White breaks off in the fifth frame. In the very pleasant position of leading by 4-0.
One.
This young man wants to put a little break together, get himself on the map.
Seven.
Still a fair way to go in this match yet.
Fifteen.
20.
Well, a very good attempt there to split the reds, but he hasn't been very fortunate. A little trickle off the side of the pack, send the cue ball down to the ball end.
James Wattana, 20.
James Wattana with a 20-point lead.
Came very close second time around, but he's quite some distance away with that pot. He'll be a little bit disappointed with that as the head goes down.
One.
And the way Jimmy White is playing today, that could spell disaster in the fifth frame. The black ball won't pot into the left-hand corner pocket, so it'll be back up for the blue.
15.
Hopefully just above it. Now can decide either to play for the single red just above and to the left of the black, which I think he probably will play for, rather than going into the pack. Oh, well, that's a rather bad miss.
2-1.
And he chipped off a red just on the edge of the pack, and that was now potable for James Wattana. So that's a good chance.
1. Eight. Nine.
Hadn't got the right angle on the blue to be able to come back for the reds there, so took the green.
Thirteen. 26-point
lead now with that red. We'll want to make this a frame-winning visit, if possible. Every chance of doing that.
He's
finished a little short on the red to the corner pocket, so choosing one of the two reds closest to the pink for the middle pocket.
28.
And there's Jim another one that's gone astray somewhat. So James Wattana 33 points ahead, but Jimmy White has a ample opportunity here.
One.
And plenty of points still to be made.
Six. Seven.
Should play the stun run through here for the red. Last of the three to the left.
13.
And that in turn will free the other two reds to the opposite corner pocket.
14. 21, 22, 28.
Yes, and Jimmy pauses, checks the scoreboard. What a mess he made of that shot. So still this
Jimmy
frame
White,
is wide open to either player. Jimmy should have really polished it off at that visit.
Good shot there from James, holding the cue ball behind the green. Oh, very nearly cut the red in. Well, this young man can pop these in very often. Doesn't seem to be his day for doing so today, but he's got a nice snooker out of it.
This one just straight up and down off the top cushion. Just got to be careful he doesn't miss the gap. In fact, he's got it on the way back. I don't think that was intended. But the audience appreciated it anyway.
One.
Will the yellow go past the brown?
Black ball.
Jimmy playing to move it there, so obviously it won't. But it probably will go into the middle.
Eight.
Or, of course, there is a snooker on.
Eight. Jimmy White.
So Jimmy takes the lead by just 3 points.
Maybe that Jimmy may be able to just stab the cue ball and pop the yellow into the middle.
Two.
But this is a difficult green now because he's close to the cushion. But one good shot here and the frame could be over.
Five.
Terrific pot.
Nine. Fourteen. 20.
So Jimmy White comes up with another one, leads now by 5 frames to nil.
I'm being a sort of typical Brit here. Here's Jimmy White racing away 5-0. I'm feeling sorry for James Wattana. Dennis, he's had a dreadfully traumatic week with the loss of his father. Do you feel his problems might be coming home to roost now?
Yeah, possibly. The longer you sit in your chair there, I mean, I can relate back to this, to 1985 when I played Steve Davis in the final of the World Championships and I was 8-0 down. And I'd lost my mum just shortly before that. And you can't stop thinking about it, but the longer you're in the chair, the worse it'll get for him. But James has said that he wants to win this for his father, so that's going to spur him on. And if he could just get the one frame, that's what I did. I thought if I can get the one frame, I played well throughout that World Championship. James has showed the best form throughout this tournament. So if he can just get one frame under his belt, then who knows? But it's going to be very, very tough for him.
How much of a spur was it to you then, the loss of your mother?
Well, suddenly I decided that snooker didn't mean that much to me. In fact, I was thinking of packing the game up, and I went the week after and won the Grand Prix in Reading, and then won the World Championship a few months later. I just went out and played the snooker, and if I lost, I didn't worry about it. And I won quite a number of tournaments in the next two seasons. It put everything into perspective, really.
Well, let's hope, for the sake of the final, that James can pull things round and certainly put the terrible experiences he's undergone behind him. As we continue now into frame six, Jimmy leading 5-0, and in fact 5-0. Commentators again, Jim Medicroft and John Pullman.
Well, a very risky one to take on there, but I do believe that Jimmy's got away with it. Can't see anything very simple on there. This is a very tricky one into the middle pocket.
One.
Well, that was an incredible cutback on the red. Didn't really look potable from our commentary position. But of course, the black was ready and waiting over the corner pocket. But he's playing it cushion first.
Eight. 9.
Jimmy's certainly in cracking form, it must be said. When he's on song, there's no greater putter in the game.
Sixteen. 17.
That's beautifully negotiated. Screw back for the red just above the black into the same pocket.
24. Jimmy White.
Oh, it was a little bit dodgy, as you could see, almost, but not quite, and you can see that there is no fall at all on the pocket.
1.
Virtually straight. That's the reason that the ball tends to stick right on the lip.
9.
Oh, that's a great shot. Perfectly 16. Negotiated. The cannon into the reds. Oh, that's 17. Not run as planned. Possibly got rather thick contact. So this is a difficult black.
17.
James will be a bit disappointed with that little effort. He knew that he had a great chance there. And Jimmy on this occasion having the cue ball cleaned. Probably James would have been better off having that job done before playing the black, actually.
1. 8. 8. Jimmy White.
Well, what is happening at the moment? Gone off the boil.
One.
It's quite amazing, really, the similarity between the two players. They both play very much the same game. And both very quick thinkers also.
15.
Certainly get on with the job.
16. 22. 23. 30.
Well, James with a 10-point lead.
31. 38. James Wassenaar, 38. One.
We won't see many better pots than that this week.
Eight.
So 10 points in the frame. Jimmy just needs to slide this red into the left-hand middle pocket.
Nine.
You'd probably like to play the yellow ball into the middle pocket, but the yellow ball won't pass the green, so he's playing the more difficult green. Always played that to perfection. Took all the power out of the shot. And nicely in position now for the colours.
14.
Jimmy needing up to and including the pink.
21.
Shouldn't be too difficult.
26. 32 in the frame.
That's it. And Jimmy gets another frame on the board. Leading now by 6 frames to 0.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. 7th frame, Jimmy White, 2 break.
It's not often one breaks off in the 7th frame of a match, leading by 6 frames to 0, but that's the situation at the moment for Jimmy White.
One.
Jimmy's played some quite extraordinary snicks so far this afternoon. Wonder if he can cut this black back. No problem.
8. Jimmy White.
8. This young man approaching the table. What a week of snooker he's had. Filled with ecstasy and trauma. And this really will be a test of character.
1
for James Wattana.
1 James Wattana.
And it just won't come right. Now Jimmy can obviously pop this red past the other one, having another look, as he was looking to see if the black would go. There's going to be a lot of room there.
One.
Jimmy really got the bit between his teeth.
Eight.
Me and my big man. But the way that he's been playing this afternoon, an unexpected miss. But another chance for James Wattana.
One.
And he's really going to have to do something if he's going to make any impact on this match.
Nine. 16. Seventeen. 24. 25. 32. 33.
Yeah, a little bit close to the cushion.
40. It's
safely negotiated and still in good position.
41.
6 black there. James Wattana's best break so far in this match.
48.
Gives him a 33-point lead.
Possibly one of those reds just to the side of the pink, the outside one, maybe pot. Obviously not. And there's a mistake. I wonder if he's got away with it, though. Looks as though the red is covered, but Jimmy possibly could come cushion first.
One.
Pink ball to the corner, and the possibility of dropping onto the two reds just by the side of it. But not quite worked to plan. Hoping to push the red a little further forward.
Seven.
So back to safety.
Seven, Jimmy White.
He's got quite a following this week, James Wattana, and the crowd willing him on to pot the balls. He's certainly made a few fans this week.
Six. Six, James Wattana. Ball stroke, four, James Wattana.
Well, unfortunately then, not able to hold the cue ball. It's a good pot, in fact. Knock the red in. Eight points of difference now in James Wattana's favour. If he could get rid of one of these reds and the colour, he'd be well on the way to getting his first frame on the board.
This must be very tight to get past the blue, as you can see from that picture.
One.
And in goes the red. You're heading towards the blue from this position.
Seven.
little bit tricky to negotiate position on the yellow ball. That's why he's coming round just to check.
Eight.
In fact, if the green goes past the yellow ball, he should be in business.
Brown ball.
He's having to choose the brown. The green won't go past the yellow. He's got to be almost weight perfect on this shot. It looks as though
12.
He's got exactly where he wanted to be. Green to the 14. Right middle pocket.
Seventeen. 21.
Needs the brakes on that, and he's just about managed to stop the right side of the blue to come towards the pink. Jimmy requiring the three remaining balls to take the frame.
26. Thirty-two. 39 in the frame.
And Jimmy White does it again. Now leads 7 frames to nil.
It's a ruthless performance, isn't it, from Jimmy? Dennis, there's a couple of shots I'd like to take out of frame 6 that I think illustrate how well Jimmy is playing. I mean, look at this.
He can play all sorts of shots. That was way past the line in the middle pocket, and to cut that ball back in was absolutely terrific.
1.
Super shot that, and he finished up potting the black there off the cushion as well. And then there was another shot that came up. It just shows you how delicate that Jimmy White can hit the ball. He's the most powerful player in the game, but look at that delicate little pot there. And from that position, he went on to clinch the frame. He's playing brilliant stuff. But having said that, James could have won 3 or 4 of the frames.
Yeah, well, it just shows, as I said, it's the ruthless streak, isn't it? And James is inexperienced, I would have thought, at this level.
You've got to be ruthless at this game because it can turn round, because only one player can be at the table at once.
And all this coming after quite a dodgy year for Jimmy.
Yeah, he hasn't picked up that many ranking points. He was very disappointed with his performance, but this has certainly put him right back in the top 4 again.
Dennis, thanks very much. Well, let's move on now to frame 8. Only 2 more frames this afternoon, and Jimmy looking very good indeed.
Eighth frame. James Wattana to break.
James Wattana must be despairing by now. Doesn't seem able to win a frame at all. Jimmy White leading by 7 frames to nil.
One. 3. Jimmy White, 3.
And Jimmy playing with quite some inspiration this afternoon, but he's still missing the occasional one that you'd expect him to pot. And James Wattana has had several chances to come back at him, but just unable to start firing on all cylinders.
One.
Very good pot there. No certainty of getting on to a red after this black. Well, that's not too bad.
Eight. Nine.
Oh, dear. Probably got a bit of a kick with that shot, because the cue ball should have kissed through.
Yellow ball. James Wattana, no.
There's a bit of frustration in that shot, but he's done a bit of damage. Reds are spread now around the table, so one initial good pot from Jimmy, which he hasn't got on this occasion, so perhaps the table's turned somewhat. He'll probably be very straight on this red, coming round to have a look to see whether or not he can be on the black, but that is easier said than done.
One.
Very well played.
Eight. Nine. 16. 17. 24.
Now, this will help 25. His confidence a bit.
32. 33. 40.
He's going well at this stage, but not quite far enough up the table with the cue ball, so running away 41. And having to play the blue to come back towards the reds. 40. Nicely back in position, I think.
46. 47. 54.
55.
The black ball is one that James is looking for. That should put the frame safe.
62.
And I think we should be ready for a tremendous round of applause, which he's going to get from 63. The audience here. When he eventually wins this first frame, which I'm pretty certain that he will, even though he's missed the black.
63, James Wattana. And the frame.
Okay, Jimmy White can see. James Wattana, at last, he's got a frame on the board. Jimmy leading now by 7 frames to 1.
Yeah, and our friends in Thailand are watching this live, so I just think they'll be feeling a little happier after that, Dennis.
Yeah, and James will be feeling a lot happier as well. But I'm wondering if that puts a little bit of pressure on him. You know, they went live to Thailand in the Mercantile when he played Stephen Hendry in the semi-final, and Stephen beat him 6-1. Now, I know James's manager says it doesn't put any pressure on him, but being a player, I think James knows it's going to 20 or 30 million people, and he wants to do so well for them as well. It might add that little bit more pressure to him, but he should be able to relax now he's got the first frame, because it's very embarrassing not having won your first frame.
Well, it's around midnight in Thailand, so I hope they're going to stay up, because they're expecting to watch the session this evening live as well. Let's hope, anyway, the afternoon session can be finished on a high note for James. Hello again from Derby in the final of the British Open. The last frame of the afternoon session coming up now. Jimmy White is in the lead by 7 frames to 1. He's up against James Wattana, of course. It's the 1st to 10, remember.
9th and final frame of this session. Jimmy White, 2 break.
So, the last frame of this afternoon session. Jimmy White breaks off. And James Wattana, much happier now that he's got a frame on the board, trailing by 7 frames to 1.
It's not a very good shot from James Wattana. Didn't want to push the red to the corner pocket.
One.
Can't afford to leave Jimmy on the way that he's playing this afternoon. He's in devastating form. That one hasn't worked quite out to plan. Just checking to see if he can pot the red that he's very close to with the cue ball. Obviously it does go.
Jimmy White, 6.
But yet another one that's escaped, just trapped in the jaws of the pocket, but fortunate for Jimmy, it's covered by the other reds.
One.
Clever little shot then by James Wattana. The red being over the corner pocket made that quite a big pocket with the second red.
Three. Four.
James Wattana desperately needing this final frame of the afternoon session. He was to have at least a glimmer of a hope of winning this match.
Eleven.
12. Twenty. Twenty-seven. Twenty-eight. Thirty-three. Thirty-four.
Well, I haven't played that quite hard enough to get on the red. I'm going to try to make a plant now.
40. James Wattana, 40.
11 played that safety shot, that snooker actually, into perfection. Very, very close indeed. Cue ball to yellow. So Jimmy's going to find some difficulty here in trying to hit possibly the red to the right of the black, the single red.
Well, that was a good shot, and it finished absolutely perfectly for Jimmy.
34 points behind at this stage, and he's looking at a difficult red along the top cushion, but may decide against that. No, he's chose to take it on. If it goes in, it could prove to be a winner. But it was difficult.
One.
6. Seven. Fourteen. Fifteen.
So nicely on the pink. And nicely on red. And he's nearing the winning post now, and this ninth frame.
21. 22.
Red has put him safe, and the black should assure him of the frame.
29. 30. 37. 37. And the frame, James Wattana.
Jimmy White concedes, and after the afternoon session, it's Jimmy White who leads by 7 frames to 2.
Tremendous relief for James, but Jimmy, 7-2 up, surely he cannot fail to win the title now,
it
Dennis.
It would take a brave man to bet against Jimmy. He has played really consistently throughout the day, but James has won those last two frames, and snooker is a funny old game, you know, and James will certainly feel a little bit better now at the interval. He's got a couple of hours to go and relax before this evening session.
I would think it's important for Jimmy to hold on to his concentration now.
Yeah, funny, Jimmy was saying yesterday in his semi-final he was shattered in the afternoon and he went and had a couple of hours sleep before the evening session against Steve Davis. He said it's something he's never ever done and it paid off for him yesterday. I don't know whether he'll do that today or not. He's got Alan Stockton, an old buddy of his, that's looking after him again.
Yes, and John Stevens, yeah, they're two guys. They're not particularly involved in snooker as such. They're man management people, I suppose.
Yeah, although Alan Stockton is the lad that's knocked about, he's a good snooker player, and Jimmy practices with him, and he'll keep Jimmy relaxed and get him ready for this evening session.
And what should James be doing?
Well, James has just got to think about the last two frames that he won and go out this evening. The first game is going to be very important. If he can win the first frame, we could still be in for an unbelievable, memorable match.
Well, let's hope we get it. Dennis, thanks very much. We're back on ITV this evening, in fact, at 10 to 11 for the final chapter in this remarkable week at the British Open. For now, though, from Derby, goodbye. Jimmy White was almost unstoppable this afternoon. The whirlwind blasted his way to a 7-frame lead in the Pearl Assurance British Open.
And that was an incredible putback on the red.
One.
I'm not so many better pots than that this week.
It was a sobering experience for the typhoon, James Wattana, after the intoxicating events of the past few days, but he kept in touch, just, winning the last two frames of the session to finish 7-2 behind. Good evening from Derby as we write the final chapter of this year's Open. There's £75,000 awaiting the winner. It's the best of 19 frames, so the first to 10 will lift the trophy. Jimmy, very much the favourite. All the pressure on James Wattana, millions watching in Britain, millions more back home in Thailand. But at the Assembly Rooms Derby this evening, it was mighty lonesome. Very different for Jimmy, poised surely for his first title in over a year, just three frames from becoming British Open champion 1992. The arena packed to capacity for the second time today, the first frame crucial for James.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. 10th frame, Jim Wattana.
The last session of the 1992 Pearl Assurance British Open. James Wattana breaks off. Young man with a lot of work to do. Trailing at the moment by 7 frames to 2. And his opponent, Jimmy White. So first chance here for James Wattana, if he can snick this one in. Nicely on the black.
Eight. Nine.
Well, this is the type of start that James Wattana was looking for this evening. It's very important to him that he possibly takes the opening two or three frames, I think, to really be involved in the match.
16.
Should Jimmy White win this opening frame, he could become very despondent.
17. Twenty-four. 25. 30.
Things have gone astray. Not enough pace in that. Forced into playing the safety stroke now.
James Wattana, 30.
A valuable 30 points on the board, but could easily have been more. He's got an immediate chance to make it more.
1. Six. 7.
14.
Perhaps a little bit short on the blue, but shouldn't cause any real problems. He has a red to the left-hand corner pocket.
20.
It looks fairly straight, so if we can just hold the cue ball, it should be nicely placed on the black. In fact, run through and bounce from the top cushion.
Twenty-eight. Twenty-nine. Thirty-six. Thirty-seven.
Well, long past the point. Jimmy required snookers.
And that was enough to win the all-important first frame of the evening. Could this be the start of a fight back? If you include the afternoon session, he's now won three frames on the trot, so the omen's much more encouraging. Well, into frame 11 now. We join it with James at the table, no score, looking to play safe on a red.
Jimmy's making one or two mistakes early on this evening. It's another good chance for James. That's how close the red is to the pocket. Difficulty, of course, being in control in the cue ball. Now, is he going to be brave enough to take on the green? Just having a look at what the possible rewards might be. He doesn't see anything that he likes. He'll probably just tuck up behind it.
James Wattana.
Well, obviously, he felt pretty confident to take the green on, but of course you've got to pot it. So one could assume that he's played for a red. And there it is, on your screen now. But the cue ball is very close to the cushion, so Jimmy choosing one of the other two. That's a much better shot.
One.
So the quick look that we had at those reds, there was a three-ball plant on there as well, it seemed to me. And Jimmy might look at that now. There you see it, or you should, close to the pink spot.
9.
No need to bother with that, of course, when one has got a red on, anyway. May come into play a little later. It's got a red on into the left-hand corner pocket, but the black won't go into the right-hand corner pocket, so it has to come back for colours.
16.
A choice of blue or green. That's if the green will go.
Twenty-seven. 28.
Not quite got where he intended on the blue. Overrun. So this next shot is going to be a little bit more complicated. 20. Sweeping up there, James.
33.
Not quite as hard as he would have liked there. Wanted to be more straight on this red that he's taking to the corner.
34.
Well, went a couple of inches too far there, so only one shot to play.
34, Jimmy White.
Give Jimmy a 33-point lead. Doesn't look to have done any damage there.
Well, this is going to be a big shot to take on. What a cracker.
One. Eight.
Well, has a red to the right-hand middle pocket, but it's got to be fairly precise with the cue ball.
Nine.
Well, the pink is of a big help to James Wattana.
Fifteen.
This 16. Particular match will be linked to satellite TV, so there'll be a lot of people, somewhere in the estimation of 30 million viewers watching this in Thailand. He has a tremendous following.
23. 24.
He's the equivalent of America's Michael Jackson, I would say.
31.
He's certainly a very fluent player.
38.
Very quick to see what has to be done, and he certainly gets on with it.
39.
He's taking the lead now by 6 points.
Forty-five. Forty-six. Fifty-three. 54.
24 points in front now, so just needs the 57. Yellow to make Jimmy require a snooker.
62. 66. 71. 77 on the frame.
So James Wattana pulls another one back. The frame scores now 7-4 in favour of Jimmy White.
Yes, looking much better for James with that break of 77. The match score now, as you've gathered, 7-4. And less than 10 minutes later, it became 7-5. Jimmy failing to clock up a single point. And Jimmy last night produced an amazing comeback himself, you may remember. Well, now the tables are turned with James taking his fifth frame in a row. Hello again from the British Open at Derby. Well, Jimmy White's been stuttering a little this evening. You remember he was 7-0 up at one stage. Since then, James Wattana has come back to take five frames. Into frame 13 now. The scores are level at 18 all, but all those points for Jimmy coming from fouls and misses by James. It's Jimmy to play.
Excellent shot from Jimmy White. Unfortunately for him, though, he's just sent the single red to the left-hand side cushion. James can hit that. But it's very difficult to get the cue ball safe from it. So he's coming off the side cushion to drop behind the red that is closest to the top cushion.
Foul stroke, 4 on a miss, Jimmy White.
Cue ball will be replaced. James will play a similar shot.
Foul stroke, 4 on a miss, Jimmy White.
Well, this is quite extraordinary. 26 points on the board for Jimmy and hasn't putted a ball in this frame. James Wattana thinking, why on earth didn't I do that the first time?
Quite a bit of equipment will be coming out from under the table here. Jimmy is playing off the red that is closest to the top cushion. And he'll try to get the cue ball yet again behind the yellow and blue, which covers quite a margin of the table. This time, not so easy for James Wattana. Can't exactly run into the pack, play a similar shot as before, because they usually leave a red on. It was a good effort, but perhaps not good enough. Type of pot that you'd expect Jimmy to pot 9 times out of 10 with his ability. But the opening 3 frames being very much dictated by James Wattana this evening. A rule reversal from this afternoon's play, but in actual fact he has won 5 frames on the spin. Thank you.
One.
Well, where's the problem controlling the cue ball from a shot like that? Looks as if there may be a chance of putting the pink into the middle pocket. It's a good shot. It's certainly not easy, though.
Seven. Eight.
Nicely on the black, but the red's got in the way.
Under the circumstances, 15. That was an excellent pot from Jimmy. He was very limited to the amount of cue ball that he could hit.
Sixteen. 23.
Well, this is a difficult red. Oh, what a cracking pot once again.
Twenty-four, Jimmy White. One.
Well, this is a bit cheeky. Only half a pocket there to put the black in.
Brown ball.
Hug the cue ball over behind the pink. Didn't get it far enough.
James Wattana, one.
It was rather a queer choice of reds, I thought, from James Wattana. Had a red on into the middle that might have paid better dividends.
Things just not happening for Jimmy White, but he is still two frames in front. He's got that as a buffer, hasn't got to get too impatient.
Eight. Nine. Nine, James Wattana.
Well, you'll regret that one, I'm sure.
One.
needs to get onto the black with an angle so that he can release the last red from the side cushion.
Six. Jimmy White, 13.
What an important ball that could turn out to be. That was the frame winner.
James Wattana requires a black. One. This last red and all the colours to tie.
Eight. Ten.
Well, he's going to struggle from there. Didn't get into the cue ball and get the reaction he was looking for. Now, he may decide that he can play a double, but he doesn't look as though he's squaring up to that shot.
Wattana, 10.
Happy to play the safety shot. Quite a good one at that.
Bonus. Oh, that's probably cost him this
ball
frame.
Stroke, seven, Jimmy White.
32 points the difference now, 25 on the table.
James requires all the colours plus two snookers. And the way that the blue, pink and black are situated, he's got a chance, but not ideally placed now where he is on the brown.
James Wattana, 3.
It could be in. Well, it was on its way, but just didn't have the legs. There's a possible chance from here. It hits the brown slightly on the left-hand side and can miss the blue and get the cue ball behind the pink. It's got to be spot on though, the contact. Oh. Almost.
And the frame, Jimmy White.
Frame is conceded. Jimmy White stops the rot. and leads now by 8 frames to 5.
Gosh, I think that was a relief for Jimmy. His first frame in 6, and James looked set to take it at one stage, didn't he? Into frame 14, can James come back yet again? He's managed to build up a lead of 26, but it's Jimmy back at the table.
The red over the left-hand corner pocket, blocked by at least a couple of reds. And that creates a problem for James Wattana.
Well, there was no easy safety shot on. Jimmy decided to take that difficult pot on, and I bet he's hoping he hasn't damaged the tip of his cue. I think it's okay there.
One.
It's so easy just to take a little lump out of the side of it, but everything seems okay there.
Six. Well, Jimmy may not have damaged his tip, but his chances in this frame may have taken a severe dent. As that long red went into the top corner, Wattana beautifully on the pink, and carrying a very healthy lead of 39 points.
13.
With seemingly a few more to come.
14. James Wattana, 20.
Well, he'll be disappointed at missing that red, but nevertheless, he's 46 points in front, and he was fortunate not to leave anything there. I know we say all frames are important, but this one is vital to James Wattana. If he could get to 8-6, he would be in with a great chance. If he loses it and goes 9-5 behind, I couldn't see him coming back.
A little run of the balls there. He'll probably play off the side cushion. Something along the lines as you're having a look at now on your screens. Dead weight speed.
Foul stroke. 4 and a miss. Jimmy White.
Managed to find a path through the reds and give 4 points away. I'm sure Jimmy will ask for the balls to be replaced and the shot to be played again. This telestrata, as we call it, is manually operated. Subject to human error. Ooh, that was a ball human stroke. Error, wasn't it? Four. A miscue into the middle pocket.
Jimmy White.
Yes, Mark, but an interesting point there. Because we did put the telestrata up, we know exactly where the cue ball was when he played the shot. So let's see if the referee gets it right back on the line. Because we did start the line from exactly where the cue ball was. So it's just a little bit out there. In fact, he played a different shot altogether. He's the same lines, but he squared the white.
So, James Wattana now holding a 38-point lead. And once again, he's in a spot of difficulty. You can't see the red near to the right-hand pocket, just out of your screen. And these four or five reds near the top corner don't offer an easy pot. Well, under the circumstances, that's not a bad shot at all, but Jimmy can see one red into the left-hand corner.
One. Brown ball. One, Jimmy White.
Playing to lie dead weight on this red, mustn't get wrong side of it. Just there. Isn't it marvellous, the touch of these players. You hit that ball over something like, I would imagine, 13 feet of green baize cloth at such well-controlled pace.
One. Jimmy White, one.
Jimmy just having a look there to see if he has left anything on. And that's what James Wattana is looking at.
One.
Well, that little flick on the blue may not have helped the situation. Well, there you can see it's virtually straight. So he can't do a lot with the cue ball.
Six. Seven.
Needs another red and a colour to leave Jimmy needing a snooker.
12.
Should be able to manage that from this position.
13. James
Wattana. That little effort of 19 means that there's 55 points in it and only 51 on the table.
And he got the frame. Incredibly, another one safely chalked up for James. Jimmy unable to get the snooker he needed. So, Jimmy still two frames from victory. James still plugging away. Hello again from Derby, where James Wattana is still clinging to his dream after a brilliant performance this evening. 8-6 down as we enter frame 15. But there's a chance here for Jimmy to open the scoring.
One.
Now, will Jimmy White be tempted to take the black on? This is a very difficult pot. The white's in the jaws of the pocket. You need a lot of bottle to take these on.
Eight, touching ball.
Little bit of banter between Jimmy and Len Ganley, the referee. Said touching ball, and Jimmy said to him, thanks.
Well, Jimmy was so unlucky to have left himself there when he knocked that difficult black in, but he's knocked in a super red, and he's back in position.
And
would you believe it? The white's dropped rather awkwardly again for Jimmy. And the problem with this, if he swerves around the black, it's not going to be easy to get the position. White is always going to come back towards the top cushion with the side on it, and he's left with a similar shot again to the one previous into the opposite corner pocket. Will it all work out this time?
21.
Well, that's absolutely brilliant, Mark, isn't it, to take two pots like that on.
Yeah, he'd have been forgiven for missing both of them, but he got both of them.
22.
And those two brave blacks that he just knocked in could prove very, very significant. Remember, Jimmy needs two frames for victory.
29.
And, he really is struggling in this break. Once again, slightly out of position, has a red into the middle. I think it looks as though he will be cannoning onto the blue. Well, he forgot to pot the red.
29.
It's getting tense out there.
He's taking it on. Well, just look at this for a shot. Unbelievable that, to finish on the black from that position.
And just look how open the table is now. Every red off the cushion, just the one near to the top cushion that might prove difficult once he gains positional control. It wasn't too good a black that he knocked in just now.
Nine.
Pink will spot on the blue spot. And here's a big chance now for James Wattana.
15.
14 points behind.
Twenty-four. Thirty-one.
He's now in the lead by 2 points.
32.
And really should do enough from this leave to conclusively take this frame and go within one frame of Jimmy White. What a fight back by James Wattana.
39. Forty-seven.
Oh, sorry.
47. 48.
James Wattana was very quick to spot Len Ganley putting the black on the pink. Len having a little smile there. But it's a very interesting point. Had James not have spotted that and carried on, and Jimmy White seen it, it would have been a foul shot on James Wattana. You've got to 56. Make sure that the balls are spotted correctly. Well, what an amazing match this is turning out to be.
63.
Just needs the red to leave Jimmy White needing 70. Snookers.
$71.
And there's going to be something like 20 or 30 million people in Thailand sitting on the edges of their seats watching this.
78. 78. And the frame.
Jimmy White's conceded, so James Wattana takes framed under 15. And now trial by just one frame, 8 frames to 7.
A terrific break of 78. What a thriller it's turning out to be. He showed his brilliance earlier in the week with that 147, now showing his fighting qualities as well. Into frame 16, we join it with James to play, just a 2-point lead.
'Jimmy White attacking safety shot opened the balls up, but James can get through to this one. 'Now has it paid dividends? Jimmy White opening the balls, forcing James to have a go at the pot. It looks as if he may have got away with it. There's only one possible pot, and that's the one down into the right corner.
1.
Doesn't he make those look easy?
6. Seven. 13.14. 21.
Well, he's not having too much luck when he's trying to disturb the reds. 2 or 3 times they've gone rather sour on him. I'm just having a look to see if there's a plant into the corner. He's going to have a go at it. It's not absolutely straight. He's got to be very, very careful.
22.
Over that hurdle.
27. 28. 41. 41.
Well, you've just got to admire Jimmy White here.
48.
He only knows one way to play the game, and he's under extreme pressure out there. And what's he doing? Just playing his natural, talented game.
49. 56. 57.
55 in front, 59 on the table, and in goes the crucial ball. Nice little cannon this time on the reds.
64.
And Jimmy will feel a lot happier.
65 71 72
magic.
79. 85.
And he'll be feeling pretty good now. Let's see if he can knock in the rest of the balls.
86. 93.
And what a time to make the highest break of the match.
95. 98. 102.
And there's a happy Sean Hall, a great Jimmy White fan.
107.
Jimmy's second century of the tournament. And where's he going to stick the black ball? This could go anywhere. 113. He played the delicate of shots. But that's a brilliant break of 113 for Jimmy White. It puts him back into the lead. He now leads 9-7. Just needs one for victory.
The man's a genius. Well, now at last, Jimmy's nearly scaled the summit, just one frame from becoming British Open champion for a second time. Frame 17, vital to both.
Seventeenth frame, Jimmy White to break.
Lynn Ganley announces the 17th frame of this match. Is this going to be the last frame? It will be if Jimmy takes it, needing just the one. And a pretty good opening break. Now, can James Wattana win the last three frames?
And I think James has covered that red that's near the left corner pocket. But there is a possible one that'll pot into the opposite corner. It's a risky one. But this man doesn't mind the odd risk.
Jimmy was forced into taking that. If it had stopped out, he'd have been in serious trouble. It was a great pot. Forced into playing the pink.
Pink pot. One, Jimmy White.
Well, that's not a bad shot at all. The red near to the left-hand top pocket is covered. And of course, there's a possible cut into the right-hand corner pocket. But a difficult position for James Wattana. Almost tight on the ball cushion.
Yes, Mark, I was just thinking there, it's a good thing Jimmy didn't pot that pink. Otherwise, he would have been in this position. Well, he was in so much trouble, he tried an incredible cannon to knock the red over the pocket in. But just have a look at the balls, and James knows that Jimmy White has a great chance here.
One.
It's not going to be easy for Jimmy. It is a frame that would win him the championship.
Six. Seven. Thank you. 12. 13. 18. 19.
Must make sure that he misses the balk colours here.
24.
If the black that he's looking at slips past the two reds into the left-hand pocket, he can take the straight red into the right-hand corner.
25. 32.
It's a little bit awkward now. He's got the red into the right corner pocket, but he's just looking to see if he can get the cue ball past that red to get down towards the blue or one of the balk colours, but it's just a little bit awkward. So we'll have to judge this one. Absolutely perfect.
33. Yeah. 38.
Beautifully judged. Absolutely perfect weight of shot. And now the red next to the black will release the black into both corner pockets. And now the frame
39.
And the match and the championship there for the taking.
46.
What a week this young man has had. Unbelievable. And what a week this man on these hunkers has had as well. He's only won 3 ranking events in his 12-year career.
46,
and would you believe it? It's not over yet. 47 points the difference.
One. Eight.
And if he manages to salvage this frame, this will be one of the great escape acts.
9.
Under the severest of pressure, quite unexpectedly getting to the table when it must have seemed that all was lost.
16.
Yes, there's a red up there, and there's also a pink.
16.
May play to get on the blue, but the pink is an option that's available to him.
17. 22. 23.
Well, this is quite remarkable stuff here we're witnessing. And who's to say where it's going to finish?
The long red just passed the pink into the corner, is what he's going for. Bingo, what a shot. And what a great shot. But now it looks as though he's got the angle to come off the top cushion and just dislodged the last red. Not quite. And the double's not on. So now a good sound safety shot. There's only 3 points in it now.
Do you know, he's thinking about the double. But he's having second thoughts and taking Mark Wildman's advice.
James Wattana, 44.
And a good judge he is, I think.
Foul stroke, 4, James Wattana.
There's so much pressure now on every shot.
1.
It's still not going to be easy for him. Oh, and that one's got away.
James Wattana, 1.
The one consolation for James is the blue has gone into a safe position. In fact, both players need green, brown, blue, and pink.
5.
He's got an angle. He can drop in behind it, or he may elect to cannon the blue out.
Nine.
So, Jimmy White. A long blue, he'd be perfectly on the pink.
14.
Well, what an absolutely fantastic finish this has been. And it's Jimmy White who takes the 1992 Pearl Assurance British Open Champions. Absolutely fantastic. And isn't he over the moon?
Appreciation for both players, James Wattana and Jimmy White.
And a consolation for James, the runners-up check with extras.
And now, first of all, to the runner-up, a check for £45,000, another check for £31,000 for his maximum break, and his top break goes to James Wattana. Ladies and gentlemen, to the winner, a cheque for £75,000, the trophy and the title of the 1992 Pearl Assurance British Open Champion goes to Jimmy White.
in the end, it was far closer than we'd have expected. My goodness, he made you sweat, didn't he, Jim?
Totally did. I was hit by a typhoon.
What do you think made the difference between this afternoon and tonight?
Well, James missed a lot of balls today, and I didn't play that great to be 7-0 up, but I was, like, capitalising on his mistakes, and I was stealing the games from the end, and towards the end of the game, and then James won the last two this afternoon. And then he came in and he won the first three, which I know he's capable of winning, you know, that amount of games on the trot. So all of a sudden it's 8-7, now it's on top, and I'm sort of thinking, well, like, really, it's only seven, like, we've both won, I've won, he's won 7-1 since I was 7-0 up, obviously. Yeah. But, I was just pleased with the way I hanged in there. I was prepared for it, like, I got 47 that game, but James looked like he was cleaning up, and I think it was the first shot he'd missed all night.
Did you feel slightly rattled when it became 8-7?
Well, you can't help be rattled when, if you know, someone, I do it to other players myself, when someone comes at you like that, it's, you know, he just played fantastic stuff and I couldn't do anything about it. I was trying to put him on the top cushion and he just kept knocking him in.
What's it mean to you to have won this title?
It means a lot to me because I haven't won a ranking tournament for 13 months, so it's just what I need, a boost for, like, the World Championships and then the Irish Benson. You know, see the slide on this crew, the Irish in Ireland, and I'm just pleased to, you know, I've got a ranking tournament under my belt.
Now let's have a word with you, James. Really, you lost it this afternoon, didn't you?
Yeah, I play really bad. I miss a lot, as Jimmy said, and that's how it goes, you know.
Were you nervous this afternoon?
No, I was feeling okay, but sometimes when you're feeling good, you just couldn't, you can't get going. You can't play well at a time, you know. Everyone is a human.
So why do you think it changed tonight?
Well, because I try harder, and he needs three, I need eight, so... So that's how it goes as well, and but you know, I was pleased to come back to 8-7 because, I mean, pleased the crowd as well, and then put him in some, you know, in
a press. Yeah. It's been a very difficult week for you.
Yes, so far, I mean, could have been worse, could have been better. To get where I am now, I must be pleased. And congratulations to Jimmy as well. You know, he hasn't won a ranking even for, I don't know, for
over a year.
Mm-hmm. And I haven't won one yet.
Well, there's still time, I'm sure. What now for you, Jimmy? What's next?
Nothing. I just go home. I've got a christening to go to tomorrow and just practice. I'm going to Belgium next week and really, you know, get ready to go to Ireland and then the embassy in Sheffield.
Celebrate tonight?
No, I'm too knackered.
Jim, well done.
Thanks.
Thank you both very much.
Thank you.
Yeah, didn't they produce a cracking final in the end? It really has been a week to remember. Mark Wildman, he's a worthy champion, isn't he?
Jimmy, absolutely. Marvellous chap. Yeah, marvellous chap.
What about his performance today, particularly this afternoon?
Yes, he capitalised on the errors this afternoon, but tonight he got a real fright. And really, the little glint of hope that Wattana had when he won the first frame tonight, it turned out into a torrent of success. And it almost looked as inevitably as though he was going to catch Jimmy and win on the post. That's how fate seemed to have planned it for him, but it didn't happen that way, and the miss blew on in frame 17 was the first time that he looked as though he was beaten. And
James has well and truly arrived there, hasn't he?
James Wattana, in my opinion, has joined the top four in terms of charisma at this stage, we'll say. He's not there in terms of ranking points, but in terms of charisma, he's with the top four as a world-renowned snooker player.
Looking back at ITV's snooker season as a whole, what particularly strikes you? I mean, we've had Gary Wilkinson arriving, Steve Davis coming back.
Gary Wilkinson winning the world match play, yes, beat Steve Davis there. Steve Davis, he had this phenomenal odd frame victory against Stephen Hendry to win 9-8 in the Mercantile, and then Jimmy today. It's probably been the most exciting series, we'll call it ITV series of snooker, we've had in the 10 or 11 years that I've been involved with ITV. So it's really been superb.
That's quite an epitaph on the season. Thanks very much indeed to you, Mark Wildman. Well, it's been a week of fluctuating emotions, thrilling, tense, dramatic, tragic, but above all, exhilarating. And we have a charismatic new British Open champion, Jimmy White. From us all on ITV Snooker at Derby, goodbye.